It's the new intro. It's the
2010s
intro. It's the big
it's so
tuba.
Clean. Oh, it's a tuba.
It's a big old tuba. VeggieTales. So that's what we're watching. VeggieTales.
Yep.
Created by Leslie Farrell
and Mike Naraki. Oh. Yeah, that. created by Phil Vischer and Mike Naraki. Is that us? Are we?
That's us. Hi. I'm Phil Vischer. Yep.
And this is Mike Naraki.
And what are we watching, Mike? VeggieTales. We're watching that show I made 30 years ago in my basement. Mm-hmm.
Yeah, we did that, and
Yep. Uh-huh. Anyway, back on VeggieTales Commentaries number 8, new co-host, moving forward, making new stuff. Kev Messick, how are you doing? Uncle Kev Messick.
Fantabulous. How are you, Finn?
I'm doing good. I haven't seen this episode in forever, and I feel like I'm going to be distracted watching it. Like, I feel like I'm going to be so focused on the episode, I'm going to just be like, you know,
You know, I've been so focused on our conversation, I realize I can't hear the episode at all.
You can't hear it?
No.
It's turned up pretty loud. I can make sure I'm sharing sound. Okay, that was the new intro. Show starts here. There he is. There's Bob on the countertop.
Sorry we had to pause the commentary there. Finn had to go to the bathroom.
Again.
He was very unprofessional. He doesn't go before the podcast.
After the first minute and a half.
Whatever it's called.
In reality, Kev couldn't hear the episode, and Kev's so picky he wants to make sure he can hear and see stuff he's watching. Which to me that's just too much, you know. I think one or the other's fine.
Well, Finn, your tastes aren't as refined as mine.
Yeah, well, I think Larry's Jeep looks pretty hot there, so, I mean.
It does, honestly.
Okay, well, we can agree on one thing.
Almost as hot as the driver itself.
Yeah, for real. Have you heard about Madame Blueberry re-saddened?
I have indeed.
I'm scared, but I'm curious to see what Big Idea Fan does. I don't have anything bad to say about it.
Oh, I'm beyond hype.
I don't have anything bad to say about it.
Can't say bad things about something that you've never even seen yet.
True. It could end up being the best thing ever. The trailer scared the heck out of me.
It'll be better than Remolded, honestly.
Well, I'm not sure about that. I feel like there's going to be like a new sweep of people making Remolded stuff because of Remolded success.
Probably so.
Phil
yeah.
saw it. Mike saw it. Kurt saw it. Presumably Lisa saw it. Also, do the line, Kev.
Like
do the line.
50,000 people have seen it.
Do the line.
Which oh yeah.
It kind of cut out, but you know, people
endless
probably
bunnies.
Endless bunnies. And here's my line. Ready?
I had a line in that scene too.
That's right. Do it. That's right. There's a good Kev moan in there if you listen closely, and then I'm and then he pokes the pee.
Baby Jacob made a cameo.
He did.
In Rack, Shack, and Benny
Jacob,
Remolded.
The baby Jacob moan is in the background, and then
did Hawk, right?
Kind of, yeah. If you listen closely, you'll hear.
I still wear my Hawk button proudly.
I'm proud of you for that. It wasn't meant to be Hawk or Baby Jacob.
I'm proud of you for making it.
Those are my default voices. Just.
That's actually what Finn sounds like in person.
Yeah, so I'm putting on a voice right now. When I sound like this, I'm voice acting. When I sound like this, I'm talking naturally. That's my actual voice.
See, he's such a good voice actor. He's had you guys fooled for years now.
And also, the lisp was fake too.
That's right.
Just like the French peace accent was fake, my was all fake too. It's still fake. Here
hey,
she is.
Look.
Look at that lady.
She's whining.
I wonder if she has nude pictures of Mr. Magoo. I think she does.
Probably so, honestly, yeah.
I love Bob and Larry singing in harmony. Something about Bob and Larry singing mm-hmm. together makes me so happy.
Mm-hmm.
I don't know why. It's just when those two harmonize, it's so beautiful. Also, we're watching on my backup channel right now. I made a separate YouTube channel just to back up VeggieTales footage because I'm making a big review at some point here. So I backed up all the classic. Anything I paid for, I backed up.
Look at that, guys. You guys are finding out about this at the same time as I. So Finn thinks of you all as his best friends, too.
I know I told you about this. Did I not?
I don't think so.
No, I saved everything just as a draft video. Every episode of the house.
Well,
every
I don't think you told me that it was on a second channel.
It's on a, yeah, it's called VeggieTales Footage for Review and Parody. So it's just backed up for the purpose of reviewing and making edits and stuff. So I don't have to have them all on my hard drive.
Look at this nude picture of Mr. Magoo.
Well, that's just terrible. Winton bought a new sink. Why, he even has a disposal, I think. Madame Lecoisie is in ceramic drawers where
she keeps her hair sauces.
She keeps her sauces in the mason jar.
I miss the Joseph O'Brien remix of this song.
The what?
The Joseph O'Brien remix of this song.
Was that Veggie Rocks or am I stupid?
No. So this guy, well, you are stupid, but this Christian artist, Joseph O'Brien, he did covers of this song and his cheeseburger on his TikTok.
Really?
A while back. You've probably seen them before. It's like the I'm so it's kinda hard to sing his version while the original's playing.
I don't think I've seen it. Was he the one who was like kind of risen you up when he was playing the cheeseburger song, like kind of looking into the camera? Yeah. I have seen that because
he took those down.
Yeah, I have seen that one because I was talking to someone a while ago who said they were a little freaked out by how he was risen.
He took those down. I was hoping he was gonna make more.
That would have been cool. I love the interior of Madame Blueberry's house. I like the wallpaper. I wanna model my house eventually, just like that. In fact, when I'm in college, Kev, if me, you, and Joe board. Let's model Madame Blueberry's house.
Let's do it. Yeah. Look, there's a couch.
Are there trees?
This is so edgy.
Are there trees in the city?
Are there trees in the city?
Yeah.
Well, we need to go back and watch VeggieTales in the City to figure that out.
True. Maybe we'll commentate on those eventually. That would be fun.
We should. We should commentate on the trees and the city.
Yes, we should. I bought them, but I can't screen share because they're so DRM protected. I love that face Bob did. He's so peeved.
You can't DRM screen share because even YouTube's like, please do not let this stuff get out.
Like, I love it. The city.
We want as few people as possible to see this.
I love it. I think it's funny. It did cost me like $150.
I love you, and I think you're funny.
Thank you. Likewise, I think in the city and in the house together, I think they cost me like $150 to get, which is a lot for a whole show. But I own it forever now, and now I can like legally make a backup so I can review it. So
I'm sorry for your loss.
Yeah, me too. Me too. I'm the guy who spent $150 on Netflix VeggieTales. Most people would never. What does it mean?
That part still makes me laugh every time.
It's big.
That's what she said.
I love his list. I miss.
I love your list.
I miss Larry talking like this. Like this.
I miss you talking like this.
I still kind of do, so you don't have to worry about that.
Sometimes, yeah.
It's just, now I can turn it on and off.
It comes back every time I need it.
I have like a switch. You know, like if I pull my ear down, if I pull my ear down, then all of a sudden I'm talking like this again.
Oh, okay. So it's kind of like Larry's retractable tooth.
Correct. It's exactly like that. I pull my ear down, and all of a sudden I'm talking like this. Push it up, and I'm able to sound more cohesive.
Wow, that's awesome.
Yeah.
Hey, look, it's the rare crackers.
I practiced the rare crackers. The scallions are absolute chads. I'm just saying.
Rare. Uh huh.
The fact they said, "Do you mind if we step in, please?" and then just stepped in. I pray that you won't take.
Do you think I could get away with that, Finn?
My house, yes. Madame Blueberry's house, maybe not.
True. And why would she have any objections to that?
She said some stuff about you, that Madame Blueberry.
Oh.
Yeah. I know about the history you two have, the complicated relationship between Kev and Madame Blueberry. She told me everything.
Did she tell you about that one time that I snuck a weasel into the nursing home?
She mentioned something about it, but she told me she couldn't get too deep into that because she didn't want you to get in legal trouble. So she still cares about you enough to keep you out of trouble.
Please don't ask her to elaborate on that.
Scratch that from the record, please.
We could both. Yeah, if you could edit this out of the video, I'd appreciate that.
I love Mike doing the.
Yeah.
Mike was truly Big Idea's sound man in the 90s. He's responsible for the
water. Yep.
Scooby-dooba.
They later got sued. Yeah, they later got sued for saying the word Scooby-Doo.
Twice. They got sued twice. Gotta check. He's so mad. He's like, play it off, boys. Act like we do have it. And those shirts are looking grungy. Here's some rope for going bungee. The writing in that book looks like the cuneiform and remolded.
Yeah. Yeah, literally.
Anytime when I was little, my dad would turn SpongeBob on the TV. He'd go, spongy, here we go, spongy. Come on.
We love Mr. Corporated in this house.
We do. He's a good man.
He is. A better man than
Scallion Scott. 1. Right. He really is.
Does he love the smell of cookies in the morning?
I'm going to venture to say yes.
Good.
I would venture to say yes. More stuff.
Stuff.
Anytime they close up on Scallion One's eyes, you know there's trouble. He's risen. That side smile. Once they learned how to make the character shrug, they couldn't stop making them shrug.
Yeah.
No, it's not. Yes, it is.
I loved the use of shrugging and remolded.
When did they shrug and remolded?
Shrugging and shimmying. There was a lot
the
of shimmying.
The shimmying was crazy. Oh my gosh, yeah. I love the shimmying. The bunny song shimmying and then the stand shimmying where Junior's like shaking his little hat. I cannot stop watching that.
Oh yeah, Junior had the moves in stand.
He did. He was killing it.
Yeah.
How many times have you watched Remolded now?
3.5. What about you?
3 full times. I watched I watched it during the premiere. I watched it the pre-premiere with Gord and his friends, and then during the premiere, and then after the premiere.
His friends, not our friends.
Wow. Our friends. I'm sorry.
I was there too, fam.
You were there. That's right. The part of the show. If I hear one more person say they want the Bear Trap song to get published, I'm gonna cry. It does not exist, guys. It doesn't exist. It's not Lost Media. Finn. It doesn't exist. What?
I want the Bear song. I want the Bear Trap song to be left as it is.
Thank you. Thank you.
My pleasure.
A rare Kev win.
Is my first win. Did they play this my song? First win was becoming friends with you.
That was a big win. I'm not gonna lie. Likewise, of course.
Aw, shucks.
The silly song came really early in this one.
It did, yeah.
My grandma used to have this one on VHS for years and years, and she gave it to me.
Aw. Typical Finn Ma W.
Grandma Incorporated. I'm sure you'll figure something out! Little construction hat pee. This would be a good time to talk about your veggie medley. Can that be discussed yet or not?
I suppose we can discuss it a little bit.
If it can't, then send me a cease and desist immediately. If it can, then we can talk about it.
I mean, that's on the way anyway.
Oh no. Cease and desist being so cool.
No.
Oh.
It's for harassment. But I would love to discuss the veggie medley.
Yes, the veggie medley.
My brainchild.
Kev Messick is making the veggie medley.
And it's going to be glorious.
And I get to sing as Mr. Lund.
And I get to sing as, like, a bunch of characters.
I get to sing as Mr. Lund. Kev gets to sing as everyone else.
And Deca PJs gets to sing as Junior.
Oh, is Deca going to be Junior now?
Yep.
Nice. I love that.
We had another
singer. We should see if she wants to get on the commentary sometime.
We should. Yeah, she seems very nice.
I don't think I've ever talked to her, like, ever.
I had never talked to her before reaching out for the project, but she seems very nice.
She'd be fun to have on here sometime.
She would.
Jerry's eyes are so big. Why are they so big? Look at his eyes.
the better to see you with, my dear.
I guess so.
Making it eggs. I can't.
We should we should redo Rackshack and Benny, or maybe commentate on Remolded.
Yeah, I was thinking about that, but I think the whole team, it would be chaotic having like 20 people on there, you know.
As if it's not chaotic with the two of us.
I'm not sure how that would work. I know 3-2-1 Blender for sure probably wouldn't do it because he doesn't do a lot of like voice reveal stuff. Everyone else we could probably convince to do it, but I'd be down to just do me and you. Maybe
you know what? We could do like 27 different commentaries on Remolded.
We have everyone coming just to speak on their parts. So the parts that we'll do animated, we'll do points just to talk about.
Yes. Cut them off mid-sentence.
Your part's over. Your part's over. Dark Gord, talk. up, your part's over. Gord, talk. Up, Kev, that's your line. Talk over it. Say like two syllables. Like, your line's over. Move on.
Endless.
Don't say if someone accidentally dropped. I love that shot. The spotlight following him. So
Finn,
hot.
So you'd hot. Better match this energy for the medley.
It's tough. Well, it's tough.
Oh, no. Finn.
What's that?
I just revealed that his cheeseburger will be in the medley.
Can you
believe it?
Oh no! You mean his cheeseburger is one of the better known VeggieTales songs and would be included in the medley of popular VeggieTales songs?
So.
I can't believe it. I'm gonna shock y'all even more. The theme song
would
might
you
be
call
in there
them
too.
All popular?
I would call cheeseburger. Oh, you know, the ones in the medley, I would not call all popular. No, I would call.
Yeah, no.
I would call maybe over half
of
them
a good
popular.
Mix for y'all.
Yeah, you've got a few in there that aren't as well known, maybe,
including one of my all-time favorite songs that
the
is
one that
not
goes,
even
someone
in
says
an episode.
I'll never win, I will not listen to him, God made me special,
Finn,
and so I'm special.
You've got a second cease and desist on the way.
Oh no. The VeggieTales in the House theme song plays like three times in the medley. It goes, oh, he will wait, for there is a wondrous place not far away.
You do know that if you look in the mirror and say in the house three times, your design changes into an in the house design.
Oh, I was always told if you looked in the mirror and said in the city three times, Jimmy Gord would show up behind you with his Netflix design and swallow you whole.
That happens too. Although, that's the pleasurable experience.
For some people, maybe.
For me, maybe.
Oh? Oh? Madam Blueberry looks so sad when you said that.
She does. Oh. I'm sorry, Madam Blueberry.
Her reaction to you saying that was like, sweet, Kev! Why must you go there?
She wanted it to be her to be eaten by Jimmy.
Kev, do your best Annie impression.
For his love that's all around. That's why I say thanks every day.
I wanted it to be bad, but it was actually decent.
I bet.
I wanted it to be really bad so I could make fun of you, but you actually did a half decent Annie. That's probably about the best you could possibly do an Annie voice. That's pretty good. That's pretty solid.
I bet Phil probably couldn't even tell me apart from Shelby.
Probably not. Yeah. If you and Shelby stood in front of Phil, Phil wouldn't know who's who.
Exactly.
You'd be and like, are you my daughter? And you're like, no, I'm Uncle Kev Messick.
I could just say hi, Dad, and Phil would be like, oh, look, she called me Dad, so that's gotta be her.
Your kingdom awaits me walking into a Goodwill. Me and you walking into a Goodwill.
We've done that.
We have. Me and Kev were in the same Goodwill at the same time. Shopping for the same things. It was somewhat conflictive.
And I ended up getting the thing.
He did. Well, you left it behind, but I sent it to you because it was like your souvenir for the trip, you know?
Yeah.
It was a copy of Incredible Singing Christmas
Tree. As if you didn't give me enough souvenirs.
I did, but you've given me a lot of stuff too. Also, package. Did the package ever come back?
It did not. But
that's freaking me out.
I talked to my mom about it, and she was like, yeah, since it's a return, that's sort of on the post office's time.
Oh.
And so it's at their leisure.
Still, 2 weeks is a long time. It only took like 2 days to get here.
Yeah, I know.
I hope the kind folks at the Roadhouse weren't messing with us. For context, Kev.
Should we?
Kev sent me, can I tell the story real quick? Actually, you tell the story. You tell it. I've talked enough.
Okay. So, yeah, I sent Finn a package, a late birthday package, and it's turning out to be a very late birthday package, because I was looking for his address in my texts, and I looked for the name of the city he lives in, and I just copied and pasted the first address that I found, thinking that it was Finn's address, and as it would turn out, it was not. It was the address to the Texas Roadhouse that we met at. So, I sent a package fully decorated in VeggieTales art to Texas Roadhouse.
I bet they were so confused. Like, what is this? Who's messing with us? It's also my fault, though, to be fair. You sent me a picture of the package like a week before you sent it out, and I just looked at the art. I did not read the address.
I probably should have looked at the text context.
Yeah, I only looked at the art. I didn't even look at the address. And that's all me.
Yeah.
I was at work when I found out, and I told my manager. I said, "Can I take a quick break and make a phone call?" And they were like, "Yeah, that's fine." They said, "What's up?" I said, "I think my friend just sent a package of VeggieTales stuff to the Texas Roadhouse downtown." And they were like,
You're actually telling somebody that you collect VeggieTales.
Oh, people know I love VeggieTales. They know I love it. I just don't talk about it obsessively. I don't want them. They all follow me on Instagram and they see my story.
Because you're a coward.
They see my story. They know I have a fixation on it. But
y'all,
I don't.
This man
I try not
a
to
coward,
like.
Just so you know.
I don't want to like excessively talk to VeggieTales to my friends who aren't into VeggieTales. You know, I'm not going to be like, hey, they're making a Larry Boy movie. But the creators, they might not be involved. What's your take on that? And they're like, I don't know. I watched it in my church like 20 years ago, man. Like I haven't thought about it in a long time. I like the hairbrush song, and I'm like, yeah. And they're like, I like the cheeseburger song, and I'm like, yeah. And they're like, I don't know. Who,
and you're
who
like,
made them.
Actually, it wasn't like, called the cheeseburger song. It was called his cheeseburger.
Basically, yeah. And I'm like, yeah. Well, I like Astonishing Wigs and Amazing Glazed. And they're like, huh? Gray
and
scallions.
I'm like, how?
Look at the gray scallions in the background.
I don't think we can afford that mm-hmm. right now, Junior.
That's creepy looking.
Aren't they pretty? Is there
anything else? They're scaring me.
Any scallion is capable of rizzing me.
Okay, now hear me out here.
Mm-hmm.
Scallion 1 shows up, he's wearing his
suit.
Oh
no, you say hear me out as soon as Junior shows up on screen. That's not good, Finn.
No, I'm talking about Scallion 1.
You'd better be.
Scallion 1, not Junior. Scallion 1 is wearing his suit and his hat when he shows up
Ooh.
At the house. And in the pictures, in the posters, in the background of the Stuff Mart, he's not wearing a suit. So he's basically a model posing without his clothes on for the Stuff Mart promotions.
Oh,
which is kind of disturbing. Look at that. He doesn't have a suit. He has his hat. In the other picture, it's black and white. He's looking at a lady, and they're smiling at each other.
He's naked.
Basically, like you can't show him with clothes and then come back. Also, Dad Asparagus is wearing a crop top. Or he's got insanely long legs. I want to take that frame and just turn that long stalk into like legs and see what that would look like.
Yeah.
That's definitely an outfit that exists. poor people.
He is slaying in it, though.
He is. He always is. Dad Asparagus can slay in anything.
True.
Bro can slay all day.
Archie and Dad might be my favorite official VeggieTales ship.
Oh, I love them so much. We need to make another... I say another, like, that was our last story we made, but we do need to make an Archie Dad story.
Yeah.
Here it goes. I don't need a toaster oven. Real. They look, bro is flabbergasted. Look at him. He can't believe it.
She has no idea what she's talking about. We all need toaster ovens.
She's nuts. The lesson should be that you do need toaster ovens, and it should shame Madam in the end. In the end, there should be like some terrible accident that could be solved with a toaster oven.
Honestly, yeah.
Like, Larry's dying, and she's like, what can we do? And Larry's like, just grab me the toaster oven from the cart, and I'll be okay. And she's like, but I didn't buy the toaster oven. And he's like, and you can't save my life, and he just dies. That would be a great ending. One of the characters dies because Madam didn't buy a toaster oven.
That should be how Resaddened ends.
Resaddened. I hope if Resaddened gets finished and comes to fruition, I hope they take some creative liberties and do some wacky stuff like that. Because Madam Blueberry looks pretty good as it is, you know? Rackshack and Mini needed remolded. Madam Blueberry, I'm not sure if it needs resetting, just looking at it. It's a pretty good looking episode.
It is.
No more! I like her little red necklace, so tiny. This part goes cold, goes hard, goes hot, whatever the word is. Whatever they say nowadays. I like the progression.
Shout out to my close personal friend, Kurt Heineke, for the score here.
Yeah, he's my friend, too. He emailed me recently. Well, I emailed him first, to be fair.
Is he your Facebook friend, buddy?
I don't have Facebook, buddy.
I don't think so.
I have Facebook, but I don't use it. I'm just in that one chat where you and Abraham Benson talk about how bad the music was. And never mind. Never mind. I almost talked about
that. Excuse
me? I'm not going to. Grab a cart, Larry. He had a mustache. Scallion One had a mustache on that poster.
Really? I've never noticed that.
A little French mustache. That was so goofy looking.
Here the timing in this scene.
So good. They even made the handle bounce.
It gets me every time.
In my opinion, Madam Blueberry is like peak VeggieTales.
Probably
like,
so,
I feel like,
honestly.
I feel like this might be a hot take. It's kind of just my opinion as of now, but my opinion fluctuates like my hormones. I think my two favorite VeggieTales episodes... Not favorite. The two essential episodes, maybe three essential episodes, for a good parody of pop culture, watch Madam Blueberry. For a good Bible story, watch Josh and the Big Wall. For a good Larry Boy, watch The Rumor Weed. Those might be my top
fair
picks.
Yeah.
If I was gonna say here's the essence of classic VeggieTales and the different genres they would cover, I would recommend those three episodes probably.
Okay, now what about a good three silly songs? Look at the coupon.
I would say Hairbrush is really solid. If you've never seen it, it's hilarious. Like, I've grown up with it. I'm desensitized to it. I'll probably never laugh watching the Hairbrush song because I'm so... But if I had never seen the Hairbrush song and somebody was like, look at this cucumber in a towel, I would...
That part makes me laugh every time.
Yeah. Hey there. Three silly songs for me. I'd say Hairbrush, Cheeseburger, and... Maybe
Angel?
Love My Lips... Pizza Angel's pretty good.
Yeah.
Maybe belly button, Hairbrush, and Cheeseburger, but I'm not sure. How about you?
I would also choose Hairbrush and Cheeseburger.
Cheese Hairbrush?
But yes, cheesy Hairbrush.
You just said Cheese Hairbrush, I think.
Did I actually?
That. I think you did. I said
Cheeseburger and Hairbrush.
I thought you said Cheeseburger and his Hairbrush or his cheese. I don't know. We'll have to go back. We'll have to go back and listen. Maybe my brain is playing tricks on me.
His Hairbrush and the Cheeseburger song.
Fair. And how about the third one?
And either Love My Pizza or Lips Angel.
I feel like Cheeseburger and Pizza Angel together would make people think silly songs are primarily about food.
Yeah.
I'd probably show one or
Although,
the other, and I feel like
people think that about Weird Allen. So
they think his songs are
just
about
That's
just
what
food.
Comedy music in general is. Yeah.
Oh. Remolded reference.
Yep.
There was a Remolded reference in Madam Blueberry.
What a ripoff.
Madam Blueberry
Honestly,
is a ripoff.
I don't know if I can continue to watch this after.
Let's turn it off. Let's go watch Phineas and Ferb.
Yeah. Phineas and Ferb resummered.
Let's watch Top 5 Times Candace Busted Phineas and Ferb by Jed Kopo. That's in my recommended.
Uh-oh.
There it goes. Bye-bye.
Oh, no.
That's a bare tree. That tree's going to be so much healthier now.
The tree's naked.
The tree is free. The tree can now grow and sprout like it was meant to. Boom. I have a very...
Well, they have a house now.
No more house. I have a very clear memory of watching this at my grandma's house, and my grandpa came in and was like, "What's going to happen to Madame Blueberry? Is she going to be okay? You think she'll be okay? What's going to happen to Madame Blueberry?" That type of thing. I think he'd seen it before.
Nice. I like have a very clear memory of watching If I Sang a Silly Song with my grandfather.
Aww.
And he was half asleep. And when the narrator goes, "Isn't that awesome?" He like popped up and said no. Because he was half asleep. He had no idea what was going on.
That's funny. average Grandpa Kev win.
Yep.
I'm going to keep saying average fill in the blank win because I think it's funny.
I don't think it's funny. We should I think get, it's hilarious.
We should get your grandpa in the commentary.
I mean, we'd have to go back in time a few years.
Oh, my bad. Sorry about that.
All good.
Likewise.
All good. He's listening down on us.
He is. He's
and either smiling or cringing.
Ask him if it's awesome.
Hey, Pops, isn't that awesome?
I could feel the no. I could feel the no. We dedicate this commentary to, you said Pops?
Yep.
To Pops. We dedicate this commentary and the If I Sang a Silly Song commentary to Pops.
That's right.
The grandpa who talked about Madame Blueberry is still around, but my other grandpa isn't. Aww. There they go. Look at them crying. Aww. They got those VeggieTales show eyes.
It's this is the result of us talking about our dead grandfathers. we even got Bob and Larry sad.
Well, I appreciate their sympathy, don't you?
I do, yeah.
Where were we? I love how they lose it again.
Aww.
Fun fact, I'm sure you know this, but maybe some people in the audience don't. They were going to cry at the end of Pause, too. In the commentary, they said they were going to have them come back and be crying again, but Phil didn't do the gag twice. Swing it, peas. Oh, Bob. The peas look so bewildered. I always love how goofy they look. Their little eyes.
They're like curious puppies cocking their head while looking at you.
They do look like that. I want to hug them.
Yeah.
They're so mischievous. I like how Petunia treats them like kids and VeggieTales in the house. She goes, "Oh, you boys. You naughty boys."
Always trying to get me to help them with their math homework. Cordy had the birth
for us today. Okay. Wait, which one was that from?
Sorry, we're closed today.
Right. Proverbs 15. In one of the ones, I think it was the awesome frosting mustache. They weren't helping Petunia set up for the concert, and she was like, "You naughty boys."
Yeah. Being greedy
sure brought trouble to Madame Blueberry's house. It sure did, Larry. But even before Madame Blueberry's house got smashed, being greedy made Bob's like talking from a different place here. I don't know how to describe it. I don't want to be a grumpy. Just a different tone.
Post cry clarity.
Yeah, something like that. I'm going to be thankful for what I do have. That's great. Phil really was amazing with his performance. And still is, because the Phil and Mike show continues the legacy. So are they inside costumes right now? Because I just can't with that.
I think so.
No, it makes my heart hurt to imagine Bob and Larry are people in costumes. Plus, Phil and Mike would have to be teeny little people because they've talked to other people, so you'd have to imagine them talking to other people in interviews. But I guess it would make sense why Bob and Larry are almost as big as the people sometimes.
Yeah.
Does VeggieTales even have canon?
This is an excellent question.
It's just a show. The modeling team, Steve Leeper.
Just a show? Just a show?
It's just a dumb kids cartoon. Just a stupid preschool show that teaches girls about true beauty
fair.
And what it's like to be a penniless princess.
That was the lesson.
I remember the promotion that came out with Penniless Princess where Leslie Farrell overpriced the DVD and convinced a bunch of middle-class families to buy like 30 copies so they would be poor and learn what it was like to be the Penniless Princess and face hardship along with Sarah Crewe. She wanted the experience to be more real. She said, only available to the middle-class families. Each DVD costs $150. You cannot buy one without buying 30.
And it worked.
It did work. Found a valuable lesson. Lots of stuff. Lots of Mart. Anything to say about these credits, Kev?
Well, we're about to pass the thankfulness song, words and music by Phil Vischer, produced to Rain. Hey, you're going too fast.
On the beautiful blue, what?
Score Kurt Heineke. Content advisor Scotty May, Lisa Vischer. Special thanks, Mark Bugzik, Chris Olsen. Hey, going too fast again. Executive producer Phil Vischer. Stuff la la la.
The effort was
his
there.
Cheeseburger.
His written cheeseburger and directed has a by Mike Naraki. Credit section?
Yeah.
Interesting. I never knew that. I never watched all the way through the credits when I was little.
But not... But Finn!
I didn't care about who made it. I just knew Phil Vischer because I had his book. And I knew Mike Naraki because I liked Larry. And then I found out... John Waba. I didn't know who John Waba was until I started, like, you know, being a fan and not a, you know, not a casual fan. There's the logo. I'm gonna sneeze. Sneeze with me, Kev.
Bless you. Okay, 3, 2, 1.
Chew.
Ha, I didn't do it. I made you sneeze by yourself.
You suck. You're
bye!
Not.
Bye!